One thing that I found that junior developers struggle with, because I remember this myself at one point, is really understanding the full ecosystem of the software delivery lifecycle. And I'll kind of explain what that means. Understanding, okay, what happens to your code, you know, when you open a pull request? What tests are running? What do you need to be thinking about? What are the dependencies and conflicts? How do you go through that cycle? What happens after your code gets merged? What happens after it gets deployed? How do you measure if it's doing well? You know, when you're a junior developer, at least for me, I was like kind of living just in my little world, just I'm developing. And the more I think you can show a junior the full ecosystem early on, then they're like, oh, this is how it really works. So one tip that I have, I always tried to get at any employee, but especially the juniors, get a task end to end done quickly in the first few weeks, even if it's just changing something small so they can see that full life cycle and get code out to prod. I think that helps. Have you seen, what do you think about that?
Absolutely. We actually have our new hires releasing code to production on day one. We give them a handful of ramp up stories. The first couple of days, a lot of them are text changes, very simple cosmetic changes that, exactly as you said, allow the new engineer to see the entire development lifecycle end to end, so they at least understand what's going on before they have to figure out a complex issue, get the fix in, and then get it out to production. So making sure that they understand how it works, how we do what we do with the simple tasks,
yeah,
has definitely helped.
Super important. I mean, I think that's one of a good takeaway from this pod.